We're constantly talking about whether we should use the preview provider or should we stick to the simulator instead. What we don't do enough of though is actually take the best parts of both and combine them into one. So today we are just going to do that. We are going to add hot reloading to the simulator. I know, this one's going to blow your mind. And if you want me to help in your code, or maybe you want to learn SwiftUI, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, a 60-minute Zoom call with me. If you have any questions about SwiftUI, or you just want to hang out with me, go ahead and check out. The link is in the description. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, what are we going to build out today? Well, it's a mind blow, as I told you. Let me just demo it for you. So here is Inject demo. I'm just going to build and run right over here. As you can see, it says hello inject. Now let's just add in here free. I'm not closing the simulator. I'm just adding some new changes to the content view file, and I'm switching back to the simulator, and there we go. We have hot reload on the simulator. The best of both worlds. Now you have, you know, the navigation and the data fetching from the simulator, those good parts, and also hot reloading the good parts from the preview provider. So today we are going to show you how you can set all of this up. Trust me, it's really, really straightforward. So let's just dive into it. Make sure that you check out also the chapters if you want to skip around these steps. Okay. Oh, you're still here. Great. I just want to take a moment to invite you to a 60-minute Zoom call to work with me on your project. If you need help in coding or just want to boost your SwiftUI knowledge, visit rebeloper.com/mentoring. Link is in the description. Now let's get back to hot reloading your project. So first thing first, we want to go to a certain repository, and it is Inject. So again, a link will be inside the resources, or just try to please copy this out. And we are going to use this Swift package on our project, but also this Swift package takes really advantage of injection free. Now, yeah, we are going to talk about that, but just, you know, these are the resources and this is what we are going to do. So I'm going to just start from scratch. So let me just close this project and let's create a new project right over here. Let's just name this. Let me just resize this so we can see it better. Let's just name this inject example, for example. And let's click on next. Now you will be asked, where do you want to put your document? Now, usually if you put it on the documents or the desktop, injection free will have some sort of issues because those are kind of guarded by the system. So what you want to do is just create your own folder right over here. I'm going to show with you how you can do it in just a second. So I'm just going to drop it right over there, injection example. So let me just show you how you can do that. So let me just show you how you can add these kind of folder under your favorites. So just go ahead and right click on network and open in new tab. And then what you want to do is just navigate to your user and just create a new folder right over here. I don't know, inject or whatever you'd like. And then because now this is outside of the scope of the documents or the downloads or the desktop folder, what you want to do is just drag and drop it right over here, and then you will have access to it. Of course, we are going to do on this under the work, but yeah, this is how you can do that. So let's just see what we got here. Let me just remove the preview provider. We are not going to use that. So let's open up the document. And yeah, we are going to follow along the integration tutorial. So what we need to do is just add this as a Swift package. So what we are going to do is just scroll to the code, copy that out, and then before we do that, let me just also remove the injection free. So this is the app that we are going to use. So I'm going to go to applications. First of all, let me just quit this, quit injection free, and then let's just remove it all together. So let's just move to bin. Okay. So yeah, we are as clean as we can be. We are going to go ahead and add that Swift package to the package dependencies. There we go. Let's just paste it in there. Inject. Let's just use up to next major version. Let's add that package. Okay, let's click on add package and we are there. Okay, let's see what's our next step. Let me just close this and go all the way down to the individual developer setup. Okay, you must add this xlinker interposable linker flag to the other linker flag. So I'm just going to copy this out and go to Xcode. And then for you have to add this for all of your targets. We have only one. So we just go build phase, build settings and other linker frags for the search. For the other linker frags, we want to add this onto the debug. So just paste that in there. There we go. Let's just double check. It's working. Okay. So next up, let's just take a look at our next step. Download the newest version of Xcode injection from its GitHub page. And let's just open that up inside a new tab. And yeah, these are the releases. So let's just download that zip file. And once we are done, what we want to do is just drag and drop this into the application folder. So right over here. So from the downloads, let's just download, drag and drop it right over there. Okay, so let's take a look at the next step. So yeah, we want to make sure that you drag and drop it onto the applications folder, and also Xcode is running from your applications folder. Usually it does. So run the injection application. So let's run this. Okay, let's just open it. We are going to trust it. And here we go. We have that. And you can also use open recent. I'm just going to clear out the menu so we can see that as a new one. So we don't have anything here. Open recent. And what you want to do is just navigate to the project injection example. And you want to go for the directory. So select project directory. There we go. And yeah, it should be there. Okay, next step. So select your project, and then if you run the project, this injection free connected should be added. So let's do that. Let's see if that's going to work. So let's build and run. Let's see. Yeah, usually I just want to make sure that I'm calling the injection. So yeah, we are not showing that. First of all, let's get rid of this nasty error, application scene manifest. Let's just unfold that. Let's add plus scene configuration, and that will get rid of it. Let's build and run again so we can see that it's actually working. Okay, so we no longer have any unnecessary logs there. So let's see how we can set this up. I believe that we also have to add the import injection and all of that stuff to see actually. Or maybe we just need to clean our build folder. Let's just double check on that. So under product, clean the build folder. And also what I'm going to do is just simply remove the app from the simulator. So, you know, we are going to get a fresh new start. Okay, let's just build and run. Yeah, nothing showing just yet. So what we need to do is just use the inject Swift package. And first of all, we want to either add import inject to any or all of our views. And also we can just take a shorthand right over here, a shortcut. So we can just add this line of code, exported underscore at underscore exported import inject. Therefore, all of your files will import inject. Okay, let's just go to the content view. And then what you want to do is add observe injection var inject. So let's just copy that out and add it right over here. And then on the body, so on the whole view, what you want to add is enable injection. So just like that. Let's hit Command B. Maybe we should just also clean. The very first setup, you want to make sure that it's a super clean one. Maybe we also need to open up Xcode again. We will see. Let's just see. Hopefully we are lucky. Yes. So injection free connected users and all of the path. Watching files under the directory users. So here we go. We have hello world. So let's just go hello inject. Let's just switch to that. And it's just switch the hello in word text into hello inject. And it's as simple as that. Now, one thing that you want to make sure, let me just drag this side by side so you can actually see it. Well, actually, I cannot resize this. But what you need to know is, okay, you just write here something, inject free, and on the simulator, it will be reflected. The change will be reflected when you change the window to your simulator. So if you just switch there, Command Tab is the easiest way of doing this, like switching between windows, and then it's just going to be populated, as you can already see. Now, that is how easy it is to just add hot reloading to your simulator. And if you have ever struggled with navigation stack in SwiftUI, go ahead and check out this special video right over here.